prophet Ezekiel. The hand of the Lord came upon me and led me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me in the center of the plain, which was now filled with bones. He made me walk among the bones in every direction, so that I saw how many they were on the surface of the plain, how dry they were. He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones come to life?" I answered, "Lord God, you alone know that." Then he said to me, "Prophesy over these bones, and say to them, 'Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord.' Thus says the Lord God to these bones, 'See, I will bring spirit into you, that you may come to life. Cover you with skin, and put spirit in you, so that you may come to life and know that I am the Lord.' I prophesied as I had been told, and even as I was prophesying, I heard a noise. It was a rattling as the bones came together, bone joining bone. I saw the sinews and the flesh come upon them, and the skin cover them, but there was no spirit in them. Then the Lord said to me, 'Prophesy to the spirit, prophesy, son of man, and say to the spirit, thus says the Lord God, from the four winds come, O spirit, and breathe into these slain, that they may come to life.' I prophesied as he told me, and the spirit came into them. They came alive and stood upright, a vast army. Then he said to me, 'Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They have been saying, our bones are dried up, our hope is lost, and we are cut off. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord God, O my people, I will open your graves and have you rise from them and bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you shall know that I am the Lord, when I open your graves and have you rise from them, O my people. I will put my spirit in you that you may live, and I will settle you upon your land. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord. His love is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord. His love is everlasting.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say, those whom he has redeemed from the hand of the foe, and gathered from the lands, from the east and the west, from the north and the south.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
They went astray in the desert wilderness. The way to an inhabited city they did not find. Hungry and thirsty, their life was wasting away within them.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
They cried to the Lord in their distress. From their straits, he rescued them, and he led them in a direct way to reach an inhabited city.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
Let them give thanks to the Lord for his mercy and his wondrous deeds to the children of men, because he satisfied the longing soul and filled the hungry soul with good things.
Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Teach me your paths, O God. Guide me in your truth. "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning.
Good morning.
For true love alone has the power to unite the wills of men. It is of the first necessity that we should have one will with Mary to serve Jesus, our Lord. These are the words of St. Pius X, Pope. I'd like you for a moment this morning to indulge me. Please close your eyes, all of you, and just breathe and listen. The Lord says today, "See, I will bring my spirit and place it in you so that you may come to life. I have promised you and I will do it. I will breathe my spirit in you so that you may live." What is the spirit that he breathes into us who love him? It is his spirit of love. His spirit gives us the ability to love the Lord our God with all our hearts, all our soul, and all our mind. His spirit gives us also the ability to love our neighbors as ourselves. All of God's laws that have been given to us since the beginning of time rest on these two commandments of love. So if we do these two things, we will be doing all of what God has commanded us to do. Keeping these two commandments is an expression of our true love for God. For remember what Jesus said in the last hours before his crucifixion. "If you love me, keep my commandments." Family, this is what we must do today, tomorrow, and forever. So let us do that right now. Open your eyes. Look to the tabernacle and say to yourselves, "I love you, God, with everything that is within me." Now look at your neighbor and say to your neighbor, "I love you too." And you can do that with an expression of this sign of love. Say that to your neighbor now. Let us do this every day of our lives. Let us find someone today. Let us find someone today that we will give this sign to. You need not say a word. Just do this. You'll be amazed at what God is able to do for you. Amen? May be refreshed in faith by the same life-giving spirit that emboldened Pope St. Pius X, who we celebrate today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who exercise authority in our world may be blessed with wisdom and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those suffering from depression, grief, or hopelessness may experience the healing power of God. Let us pray to the Lord. That the Holy Spirit may continue to transform every heart in this community to the fullness of love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died. May they experience the new life promised by Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. For our personal intentions that we hold in our hearts that we bring to this Mass this morning to pray for. For the special intentions of this Mass which are for those afflicted with the coronavirus and for the protection of all families, for the protection of healthcare frontliners, and for all involved in preventing the spread of this deadly virus. We pray also this morning for blessings for all members of Our Lady of Good Counsel Church and school. We pray to the Lord. We pray for birthday blessings for Deacon Tom Yoshiro, for Dolly and Minora. Let us pray also to the Lord for the eternal repose of Daniel K. Seiler, Priscilla Aguilar, for Arthur Joseph, for Cornelia Manuel Marcelo, for Yan San Rosa Ansai. For these we pray to the Lord. And together let us ask for the intercession of our Blessed Mother over these intentions as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are thou.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the help of our human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Thank you. and all the saints, Saint Damian, Saint Mary Ann, Blessed is Daniel, and from sin and saved from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who's in your presence, peace I give. My peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's all be jealous. Thank you.